Assalamualaikum and very good day to all. Welcome to the first topic of UMTMOOC on Ornamental Fish Culture. As an introduction, the first topic of this course will be on the ornamental fish industry, where we are going to discuss about the history, economic importance, and popular ornamental fish species. This introduction topic also includes the interview with few ornamental fish entrepreneurs who will give us an insight on the current development of the ornamental fish industry in Malaysia. So before we start, let me ask a question. What fish can be considered as ornamental fish? Have a look at a few of these fish species. Can they be considered as ornamental fish? To answer this question, generally it has been accepted that any fish that being cut red and cultured for reasons other than food can be considered as ornamental fish species. Nowadays, ornamental fish does not only include small little colorful fish species, but it can also include other fish like grouper, a fish commonly cultured as food fish. Just look at this huge aquarium in Dubai. You can find not only the common Japanese carp, but also groupers and snappers. So what are the basis for choosing a fish species as ornamental fish? Normally, a fish is chosen as ornamental fish due to its attractive color, unique body shape, rarities, and unique movement or behavior. Now let's move on the history of the ornamental fish. It is believed that the practice of keeping fish as pets started in China during the Song Dynasty, where colorful carps were reared in garden ponds. This hobby then spread to Japan in the 15th century and to Europe in the 17th century. However, the interest to keep tropical ornamental fish started in the 19th century with the rapid development of aquarium technology, especially the water filtering system. Since then, the European countries and the US have become the main market for tropical ornamental fish. However, since the old age, the world ornamental fish production is made of almost exclusively from freshwater fish species. The marine ornamental only accounts for 10% of global trade. In 2015, the total value of ornamental fish import by many the EU countries, which includes the United Kingdom, Germany and the Netherlands, was more than 78 million pounds. From this amount, more than 1 million pounds worth of ornamental fish values come from Malaysia. Globally, in 2015, Malaysia is the top 10 producer and exporter of ornamental fish. The ornamental fish trade in Malaysia actually started in the 1950s. During its humble beginning, the industry was exclusively dependent on the collection of wild fishes and was focused at the state of Johor. In the 1980s, the farming of ornamental fish started with about 18 farms in Johor, and since then, the industry has spread to the state of Perak, Selangor and Penang. Currently, there are almost 600 ornamental fish entrepreneurs in Malaysia, which the industry is valuing at more than $18 million in 2015. There are several factors that led to the development of the ornamental fish industry in Malaysia. This includes, first, the tropical climate of Malaysia with its rich aquatic biodiversity. Malaysia's tropical climate is suitable for year-round breeding of not only native fish, but also exotic tropical fish. Besides that, we also have an area of beautiful native fish that attract the attention of aquarium hobbyists. Secondly, we also have excellent infrastructure where our road, rail, electricity and telecommunication network is connected even to the rural area. Thirdly, the government support through its agency, such as the Department of Fisheries, also contribute to the development of this industry in Malaysia. There are special scheme, incentive and expansion program organized by the government to support this industry. And this include providing research funding to the to solve the problems faced by the industry, a topic which will be discussed a bit later in this video. We have excellent workforce. They are not only intelligent and hardworking, but also the labor costs are low compared to other countries. And finally, the geographical location of Malaysia plays a vital role in the development of the industry. Our location, which is situated in the middle of Asia and next to Singapore, the largest importer, is a bonus factor for the expansion of this industry here.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Lokman or Hakim, and I will introduce you to the popular ornamental fish species in Malaysia. Now, let's meet with few of the main ornamental fish entrepreneurs here in Malaysia, and let's get an insight on the Malaysia ornamental fish industry.
Mr. Chiu, can you please share with us a bit on the history of Chiu Tian Yang, its expansion and structure of the company?
This business was started by my father, Datuk Chiu Seng Lai, as a fish hobbyist since young and passionate on aquatic. He had been started his fish store in year 1963 at Manchester Road. He started from selling liver, guppy and cubifax worms in year 1965. Chiu Tian Yang Aquarium had been opened at Suatau Lane. Then Gamma Aquarium had been opened in Gamma Supermarket in year 1982. Later in year 1986, we moved out from Gamma Supermarket and shift to an independent shop lot next to it, which named as Aquarium Gamma. In year 1967, we had first exported the fish to Singapore from time being. We also have our own fish farm and developed into a wholesale and exported of fish. We had exported variety of fish to many countries such as Thailand, Indonesia, Japan, Hong Kong, Europe country and others. Come to year 2004, a main brand shop had been opened and located in the heart of inner city of Georgetown. It has become a world-class one-stop pet center with almost 50,000 freshwater and marine fish, which equipped with completed filtration system based on Europe advanced filtration technology. There are varieties type of aquarium fish have been selling in our shop, such as freshwater fish and marine fish. There are almost more than 300 species of fish have been selling in our shop. Among all the freshwater fish that have been selling in our shop, goldfish, koi, tetra fish and tropical fish are the main species that is most popular to local buyers.
Now that we know about what the ornamental fish industry is all about, let's just move on to the secondary supporting industry. And this includes not only the production and retail of the aquarium and aquarium accessories, which includes all the small ornaments, pebbles and that cute little fish house, but also fish food, fish health products, aquascaping and fish packaging and transport. Now, before we end this lesson, let's have a look at few problems faced by the industry. The main problems faced in this industry includes fish diseases, export facilities, uncontrolled production, and invasive species problems, which is contributed by the release of exotic fish species in the wild by aquarium hobbyists. Nevertheless, efforts are being made to solve all these problems in order to ensure the continuous development of this industry. With that, we have come to the end of our lesson for this topic. Now that you have known about the industry, I hope that it will increase your interest to culture ornamental fishes, whether just as a hobby or to make it your career. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. Till then, see you next time.